sphere can be expanded into bases of space which are obtained by applying this local operator center of origin on the vacuum. This is the consequence of this action that is consistent with homological Newtonian dynamics on the cylinder. And in fact, the rate of radical expansion also is a consequence of this action. So let's keep this in mind. There is a cylinder. But the reason why we need the cylinder is for the unitarity effect. So on the cylinder, there is a very natural definition of muon, which comes as follows. So if you take a certain number of operators, instead of different times, different cylinder times, and act on the vacuum, this generates for you a state which lives at a certain cylinder time, let's say time equals zero, and then the muon of this state is going to be the overlap of this state with the other state which is obtained by inserting the same operators in a mirror symmetric way. So here you insert tau 1, tau 1, and the mirror symmetrically you insert them at minus 1, minus tau 1, minus tau 1. So when you do this, when you consider this correlation function has to be positive in unitary series, and this is the Euclidean space version of unitarity, which is called reflection positivity. So that's why we go this way. And now, it has to be positive, so you fix an isolonic basis of primaries, in which every primary has a known one, and then we have to impose that the descendants of the primaries, which are just FM of primaries with P's, also have to have a positive norm. So you just have to evaluate this sort of correlation functions, and everything here is fixed by the algebra. And so this gives you, so what it boils down to are just constraints on allowed primary dimensions. And so these constraints have been worked out long time ago in the 70s, and for example, they are called unitarity bounds. So for example, in D equals to 4, they say that if you take a representation J1, J2, then the dimension has to be bigger than this or this, depending whether you have one of J1, 0 or not. So the reason, because of this sort of constraints and dimensions, the unitary theories are more tractable than general theories. So from this talk, I'm going to focus on unitary theories, but one should keep in mind that there are many interesting theories which are non-unitary,